Tschüss.
Dressed in shave. Well done, Dad. Come on, let's get you comfortable.
I thought I'd go to the pub for a pint.
What, that nasty, smelly old place?
I wanted to see old Carlo.
Carlo passed on, Dad, don't you remember? It's been 20 years now. You'd be much happier staying in. Come on, let's just get you comfy.
I thought I'd go to the pub for a pint.
Pub's closed, Dad.
I wanted to see old Carlo.
Much safer staying in. Pointless going out when you've got everything you need here. You'll be all right with your videos, won't you?
She's in here. Yes, she is. I can hear her. She's hiding.
There's no one here, Dad, just you and me.
But I'll find her. Wherever she is. You bet I will.
Stop it.
I don't care.
Where's Stop it!
I'll hunt her down. Oh, yes, I will.
Tell me who you're looking for. What you did, when it happened, anything, because I don't know what you're talking about and it's scaring me.
But I got to her. Oh, yes, I got to her. And I watched her as she died. Little girl, I can see you. Little girl, I can see you. Little girl, I can see you.
Sit down, shut up and stop whinging.
And if you don't like it, you can take your illness elsewhere.
It is a bit hard.
Well, Renee's attitude towards the patient's always been fine in front of me. I'm just repeating what Michelle and Georgia told me.
You sure it's not just a personality clash?
Well, I hardly think either of them would make it up just to score points.
If any patients complain?
No, but it's only a matter of time.
Well, we've only got to hold out until Monday when Donna gets back. I mean, what can go wrong between now and then? All right, I suppose someone had better speak to her.
Not Michelle or George, for obvious reasons.
No, nor me. I'm due at St. Phil's any minute. And anyway, Renee hardly acknowledges me now since our little mix-up.
Yeah, well, I'm always having words with her. What about Nick?
Nick? We'd love a little tete-a-tete. He's been sizing her up ever since she got here.
Well, Jimmy?
Oh, no. Ex-lover.
Is he?
Why are you surprised?
Yeah, you're right. Why am I surprised? Well, is there anyone who doesn't have history with Renee?
Joe hasn't.
Thanks a lot.
Perfect.
No, it's not.
Oh, come on, Joe. Think of it as a personal challenge.
I'm not good at personal.
Look, all you've got to do is establish a simple, uncomplicated working relationship with her just to get us through to the end of the week.
It's a chance to triumph where the rest of us have failed.
Don't believe me, you have got the wrong man for the job.
You're the only man for the job.
Well, you must be desperate.
We are.
The ex was much worse since the last time I saw you. Have you been using a different cleaning product? Scented hand cream?
Nothing new.
What about gardening? Have you handled any plants or chemicals?
Well, not without gloves. It's just come on out of the blue.
How long has it been like this?
About a month. It's been gradually getting worse.
Well, stress can affect the condition. Have circumstances changed for you at all?
No.
Everything all right, huh?
Same as ever.
And your father?
He's got Alzheimer's, Doctor.
I know.
Would you think that might account for some of the stress, perhaps?
You're finding him more difficult to cope with?
No more than usual.
Is there something in the last month or so that's changed? Something that's worrying you about him?
Like what?
Change of personality? Obsessive, aggressive behaviour? Can happen in people with Alzheimer's and can be distressing.
He gets confused, but that's about it.
I haven't seen him in some time. How's his leg, Elsa?
I changed the dressing regularly. His leg's fine.
I thought our nurse did that.
Doctor, are you going to do anything about my eczema or not?
Yeah. I'll prescribe a stronger steroid cream. But I want to explore if there's anything underlying the cause for this flare-up.
I should have said I was using a new detergent and saved myself the third degree.
I'm not interrogating you, Christine. Look, I know how exhausting it can be taking care of a sick loved one 7 days a week. There are places Eric could go. Daycare centre, for example.
It's not really our sort of thing.
Support group, where you can mix with other people.
I don't think so.
And you could give yourself some time out. If only for a couple of hours a week.
We're fine.
Okay, here's the deal. If you let me give you the address of a support group, will you think about it?
Yes, okay, I'll think about it. Now, can I have my prescription, please? Thank you.
Right. It's a community centre in Upton Road. They've got use of a minibus, so they can pick you and Eric up.
You're the one that I want. You are the one I want.
No.
Oh, you gave me a shock.
Right. Hmm. So, Renee, how are you?
Do you recognize this person?
Rude. Me. I don't understand. I've never had any complaints from patients before.
Well, nothing has been made officially, so let's keep this in perspective.
Well, then there must be some mistake. Perhaps they were talking about someone else. Donna, maybe.
No, definitely you.
I would never be rude to a patient. No, I'm good with people. I'm a people person.
Yes, but maybe you've allowed your standards to slip, which is why we need to talk about this now.
Well, I'm always happy to talk to you, Joe, you know that. After all, we've always got on well together, haven't we?
Yes. Yes, we have. But we're not talking about our working relationship. We're talking about you and our patients.
Well, that's why I'm so confused. You see, usually people are drawn to me. Occasionally, women take exception, but I put that down to envy. This complaint, it didn't happen to come from a woman, did it?
Well, yes, it did, actually.
I knew it.
But I don't see what that's got to do with it.
It's never from the men. It's funny, that. I mean, you haven't any complaints with me, have you?
Nonetheless, complaints have been made by respected members of staff, so your conduct regarding...
Staff. Now that explains it.
Explains what?
Personal and professional jealousy. That's what this boils down to.
No, it boils down to you being rude to patients.
Some people here have had it in for me from the start.
Well, maybe a small personality clash.
Well, it's gone past that now, I'm afraid. This is far beyond petty office politics. This is institutional harassment, bullying in the workplace.
Oh, please.
Maybe even slander.
No, it's not.
See, they've even got you on their side.
I'm not on anyone's side.
This is a campaign of victimisation against me, and don't try and deny it. But if you lot think I'm just going to lie back and let you all smear me, you've got another thing coming.
Firefighters arrived at the scene within minutes of receiving the call. Units from throughout the region were in attendance, and a plume of smoke spread over the outlying area.
I got to her. I did it. On the floor. In the bedroom. And now the girl is dead.
Crews battled with the flames throughout the night.
I watched her die. She saw me. I tracked her down. And now she's dead. She's dead because of me. I killed her.
No, you didn't kill anyone. Now just shut up. Just shut the hell up. Police say there are no suspicious circumstances and they're trying to trace the boy's relatives. I'm sorry, Dad. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to shout. I just what to do with you?
She came onto me in the staff room before she stormed off.
Why not you as well?
What do you mean, me as well?
Well, she's tried it on with every other bloke in the practice. Why should you miss out?
Why does she feel the need? Is she always like that?
I don't know. I don't really know her that well. She likes men. Why complain?
What I don't understand is why beautiful, intelligent young women feel compelled to seek sexual congress with inappropriate men.
What, you and Renee, have you actually...
No, I'm old enough to be a dad. I'm talking about the phenomenon in general. It's depressing.
As an inappropriate man myself, I don't see what the problem is.
But I think there's something going on under the skin with Renee, but I'm not sure what. Maybe you should have a word.
Oh, why me? I only got her the job. I'm not in charge of her morals.
But someone needs to tell her that she doesn't need to throw herself at every man that she meets. I mean, she just makes a complete fool of herself.
Well, maybe. But if you ask my opinion, it comes out of three short words. Low self-esteem.
Yes, you may well be right.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't knock it, because without it, there'd be a lot less available women in the world.
Oh, Jimmy. Really?
There are four programmes on that tape. That should be enough, although I don't know the way that machine chews those things up.
What's my lunch, Christine?
Lunch? A pork chop. I'll cook it for you later, when I get back. I've got to get to the chemist before I scratch my hands to the bone.
I just checked Michelle's list. Christine cancelled the last five appointments for Eric.
So? I mean, if your patient says everything's fine, then you've got to take her word for it.
I just got this funny feeling.
I get that too sometimes, but it's not very scientific. And if Christine doesn't want to talk, then that's up to her. People have their reasons, Nick. It's not our job to quiz them on their home life.
Unless it affects their health. Then it's our duty to find out what we can. She denies there's a problem. And yet her skin, the way she reacts, that's just the opposite.
So what are you going to do?
Pay her a home visit.
On what grounds? You don't have an appointment, and she's already made it very clear she doesn't want visitors.
She forgot the support group address.
It's a bit weak, isn't it?
OK, on the grounds that I'm a suspicious, mistrusting GP who thinks his patient's lying to him.
Well, now you're talking.
How are you feeling?
Like I'm the one to blame for Katia's death. That maybe if I'd have handled it better or done something differently, she'd still be alive.
Michelle, none of this was your fault.
Yeah, but I was one that persuaded her to leave the brothel. Oh, you've got to go, I can help you. It was a kidding.
You did what you could. And anyway, ultimately, Katia wasn't your responsibility.
She wasn't anybody's responsibility, Greg. That's why she's dead. That's why girls with the same hopes and dreams as me are forced into having sex with scum.
Well, the police are onto it now.
Yeah, but why was it allowed to happen in the first place? And don't tell me I'm the first person to discover a brothel in the West Midlands. Who allows it to happen? Who turns a blind eye to what's going on?
I don't know.
In our hometown, Greg, on a street we walk along every single day. What sort of country imprisons girls into prostitution and lets parasitic pimps like Carter walk free? I'll tell you what sort of country. This country. And it happens because we allow it to happen. Oi, watch what you're doing! Yeah? Yeah, I'm talking to you!
Greg, come on. Let's get out of here.
Mr. Barber, open the door.
She's up here. She is.
Fire service. 121 North Hill. Dr. Nick West. I've got a patient in the building. I can't persuade him to... Eric! I can't persuade him to leave the building. Get out of here.
Ah, forget it, Sid. I'm not leaving. I heard her.
Who?
Shh. There!
Who are we looking for?
Well, who do you think? The child. She's calling me. She's here somewhere and I just can't find her.
Okay, Harry. Shh, 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 shh. Come on. We'll find her. Let's...
Are you all right?
He's fine.
What happened? He's not hurt, is he?
No, he was cooking something. He must have forgotten about it.
A fireman, 30 years. He'd never have done that before he was ill. Cookie, I thought I'd locked him in the living room.
Then he really would have been trapped if there had been a fire. He was looking for a child.
Child? It's probably me as a kid.
No, he says she was dead.
He gets confused. It could be anything.
He said he'd killed her. What's going on, Christine?
Oh, God. I don't know who she is. He never mentioned her until a month ago. It's driving me mad and I don't know what to do. It's... as if the Alzheimer's has unlocked something in his memory. Something bad he's been trying to keep secret and now it's come back to haunt him.
Have you talked to anyone about it?
Oh, who? I don't want people thinking he's killed someone. He's a good man. But even sometimes I begin to doubt him, and if I can doubt him, what about all the busybodies and the gossips?
And that's why you've been hiding him away.
Well, what if there was an inquiry? The police involved? I mean, look at him. How could Dad defend himself? It only takes one person to point the finger. How do you know he's not responsible?
Why don't? And perhaps it's time to find out. Because isolating yourselves, that's not the answer. Nor is locking your dad in the house. It's dangerous, Christine. He's had a lucky escape.
But even if I wanted to find out, we could be talking 20 or 30 years ago. Who's going to remember that far back?
He's been talking to someone called Sid. Was that an old friend? He said your dad was a fireman. Maybe we should stop asking that.
Why was nothing done sooner? I told you about the girls, gave you the address of the brothel. What, do you think I made it up?
No, of course not.
Then why the delay in me telling you in response?
There are procedures. We can't just go charging in no matter how much we'd like to. Policing doesn't work like that.
It does if I'm caught speeding 4 miles an hour above the limit.
Calm down, Michelle, I'm on your side here.
Meantime, a poor girl is killed, but she's just an illegal immigrant, so what's it matter?
We care about all crimes. And I sympathise with how you're feeling.
I don't give a monkey for your sympathy, nor did Katya. She wanted help. If I go into a shop right and nick a bra, I'd be arrested on the spot. Show you where girls are getting raped on demand and nothing
all right,
happens.
All right, that'll do.
Well, I'm just saying...
Quiet. The brothel's been raided 3 o'clock this morning.
And the girls?
They're safe.
Where are they?
In a detention centre. They'll be held there while investigations are taking place and then their futures will be decided.
And Carter?
He's still at large.
Well, there you go. It says it all, doesn't it? The girls remain banged up while the pimps walk free.
Part of me is desperate to find out what happened to that poor girl, and another part of me wishes she'd just leave Dad alone and rest in peace. Scared. What if he did do something wrong? I know it sounds terrible, but I just want to keep all of the good memories of Dad that I've got left. Because they're fading fast already. And what good is raking up the past?
What's it good in covering it up? Hiding yourself away is not the answer. Eric needs to get out. As much free circulation as his quality of life. His ulcer's not as good as you led me to believe. Hey, and you need some peace of mind. Maybe knowing what happened will bring you some.
Maybe it'll make things worse.
It's a possibility, but we won't know unless we open the door.
Do you know what you're doing?
I'm not sure there's a precedent for this. I'm just going on a feeling. Sure, cool. Hi, Sid Vine?
Yes?
Dr. West. I got your number from one of the fire crew.
Let's put a smile on your face, because today we're going to play in a band. Let's start with the guitar.
Hello, Christine. You won't remember me, but my name's Sid Vine.
You were Dad's boss at the fire station. Come in. Look, Dad, you got a visitor.
Sid!
Drumsticks and play them. Oh yeah, let's go. Hi.
That's one angry young woman in there.
Oh, she feels responsible for all this.
Well, she is. Without her, the girls would still be entertaining clients. How are they?
Well, I've just sent four of them to hospital for immediate treatment. I mean, leaving the probable STIs apart, we've got eye infections and abdominal pains, sexual injuries, malnutrition, and suspected broken wrist. So, why did you leave it so long before acting on the information?
I don't know, Greg. I'm new to this case. Diaz Squires has been handling it. I'm going to find out, but 10-1, it's a lack of resources.
Oh, yeah, resources, that old chestnut.
Look, I've just had a lecture on how to do my job from your nurse. I'm not about to take one from you. So, back off.
About 40 years ago, your father had gone into a house that was already well ablaze. A neighbour reported a child inside, but we didn't know for certain. Maybe he mentioned it.
He never talked about his work ever.
That doesn't surprise me. Some you can't shut up, or talking about being heroic all the time. But your dad's the genuine article. What he did was heroic. But it was a failure, and he never forgave himself.
What happened inside the house?
He went inside, with others, me included, to search for the girl.
I heard him shouting her name when he was searching the room.
I was trying to get Eric to leave the building. It was too dangerous. And then he heard her calling, and he found her upstairs.
In the bedroom on the floor? Little girl, I can see you. That's what he keeps saying over and over.
But he couldn't reach her. And she died before he could save her. He blamed himself. He thought he should have got there sooner to help her. I had to drag him from the building.
And because he couldn't save her, he feels responsible for her death. To his way of thinking, he did kill her.
Something like that's going to have an impact. Your dad's a brave man, Christine. You should be very proud of him.
I am. I just couldn't bear to think of anyone thinking he'd done something bad.
Why would they think that?
Because of all the awful things he's been saying. You know the history, I didn't. I even began to doubt him. My gentle dad. Never hurt anyone in his life. I ended up putting his life at risk, locking him away so people couldn't hear him.
The guilt is beginning to taint your life now, too.
I'm sorry, Dad.
I was only trying to protect him.
I know. Now Sid's helped explain things. We know that Eric's been battling Alzheimer's, depression, and maybe post-traumatic stress disorder too. So, any help you can get, take it. The nurse, me, support groups.
And me. If anyone doesn't like what he says, call me. I'll put them straight.
Thanks, Sid. Even with all the help and support in the world, are we ever going to be able to reach inside his mind and convince him he's not to blame?
I don't know. All you can do is reassure him and tell him that it wasn't his fault. Maybe in time, he'll believe in himself.
So, this is near bashing for not doing my job right?
Not at all.
Let my patients down?
No.
You reckon I should have pushed past Christina and demanded to see Eric's ulcer?
No, I'm just filling you in on a complex situation. So you know for next time. A bit touchy, aren't you?
Yeah, maybe I am. It's been a stressful morning.
I can believe it. You look rough.
Yeah, maybe I do look rough, but these don't stink like an old chip pan.
Just to let you know, it's time for afternoon surgery, ladies and gents. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not being rude, am I?
Fancy going down the pub for a pint, Dad?
Oh, yes, please. Can we go and see Carlo?
Carlo's no longer with us, I'm afraid, Dad. But never mind, there'll be plenty of other faces there we know, I'm sure.
Sleep. I did it. Upstairs, in the bedroom, the little girl.
No,
I killed her.
You didn't, Dad. Sid told me all about it. You're a very brave man risking your life for all those people like that. I'm very proud of you.
I saw her upstairs, on the floor, staring at me.
Sam's reputation is under fire at Holby tonight at 8 on BBC One, but next, the race is on to save more innocent victims in Diagnosis Murder.